Here in this video, we will discuss about the automotive or car stoplights, which are located in the rear of the car, and they are to be warn the driver, the other driver, that the front side car which is going in front of him or her is stopping or is coming to stop, and he or she is braking. So this is what is the function of stoplight, and hope you all people are well known about the stoplight. And here in this video, we will discuss about the Toyota stoplights, how they are functioning, how they are working. If you understand the circuit, you will be able to repair the circuit. And if your car has got some problem and the lights are not coming, then you will be able to repair those. So here what we have is the combination lights, left hand side and right hand side, and the indicator which is there on the cluster, it is showing that the lights are coming on while you are pressing on the brake pedal. So these two things, and then the other thing is the light switch, which is located with the brake assembly while you are pressing on the brake pedal. So this light switch is released and it is connected in between. I mean to say that the contacts are connected together, and then the power is going through these contacts. Otherwise, while you are not pressing on the brake pedal, so this switch is off and the contacts are not connected together, so the power is not going to the circuit. So this is the function, how it works. And then the fuse is involved, 10 ampere stop fuse, and the power is coming from the battery all the time. The power is coming, the plus power is coming from here through this fuse. I'm discussing about the circuit now. Let us explain this circuit. So the power is coming from the battery all the time. The vehicle is start or stop, or key is there or not there, all the time the power is coming through this 10 ampere fuse and then going through this red wire to this switch assembly. So this is the switch assembly, which is located underneath, I mean to say, and close to the brake pedal. So while you are pressing on the brake pedal, this switch is closed, so the power is going through this green wire to this junction connector, and from this junction connector through this purple wire, the power is coming to this connector. And in this connector, the power is distributed in four further lines, are in five, all the five lines. So this is connected in parallel, all the five lines. So here you can see this yellow wire. This yellow wire is going to the capacitor, and the capacitor is there for the noise filtration. It is only passing the AC, and the DC power is not passed through this capacitor. This is blocked for DC power, but AC noise is only cancelled to the ground. This is the function of this capacitor. And then power is going from here to this blue wire, and then to the left hand side combination light assembly. This light is switching on through this power. The power is going through this light and going to the ground. So this light is coming on while power is applied over here. And the same power is going through this pink wire to the other left hand side, right hand side light, combination light, and going to the ground by this connector. So this is also, this all connector is grounded here. Then power is going through this orange wire to this LED, and this LED is located in the cluster, and it is showing you the status that the rear light has been come on. So this is the function of the Toyota stoplight. I am going to explain it further in detail. This is a little bit tricky circuit because the components are there, the connectors are there, and they are making confusion. So if we make a simple circuit, a pencil drum circuit, I am going to explain to you so that you will understand well. So here is a fuse, and to the fuse the battery power is coming, BAT positive all the time. The positive power is coming, our plus B line is coming, and this 10 ampere fuse is passing this current to the switch. Through the switch, this is the switch assembly, or the backup, the stoplight switch assembly, which is located in the brake. So from this switch, the power is coming and distributed in three lines. One is the left hand side light, and the other is then the right hand side light combination light, and then there is an LED which is showing the status, LED which is showing the status on the cluster. So then these are connected in parallel, and this is grounded. So this is the negative of the battery. So this way the power is coming from here and through this fuse, and if this brake is pressed, the switch is closed, and then power is going to these lights all are connected in parallel, are also glowing and then going to the ground. So this is what is the easiest explanation of this circuit. I explained in front of you. Hope you people understand this circuit, and hope you people learned something from this. And thank you for watching. Keep on watching. Stay tuned. Press on the like button, and then press on the bell icon, and subscribe my channel so that you will get my notifications. Thank you for watching.